Well, with over 2 million people in jail, the US has the world's biggest prison population. But some are seeing the inside of a cell because dodgy judges are getting payback from the private sector. RT's Gayane Chichakyan reports on those dishing out justice for a fee.
Two Pennsylvania judges have made a killing out of juvenile prisons. Mark Chivarella and Michael Conahan were convicted of receiving kickbacks for more than $2 million from the developers of several private detention centers. But the real crime, according to parents, is that these judges then sent more than 5,000 children to those very facilities for crimes as small as fighting on a school bus or posting a parody of their teacher on the web.
My kid's not here! He's dead! Because of him! He ruined my life! Do you remember me? Do you remember my son? An all-star wrestler? He's good! He shot himself in the heart!
Sandy Fonzo's 17-year-old son, Edward, was a budding student and sportsman when he was arrested at an underage party. Judge Chivarella locked him up for 6 months. Shortly after he got out, Edward committed suicide.
He never looked into, you know, the whole picture of the kids. Like I said, he lined them up one by one and he sent them away, shackled them, sent them to places that, you know, God knows what went on. And then he throws them back. And how does a kid deal with that? You know, my son just never recovered from it.
Eric Stefanski was 12 when Judge Chivarella sent him to jail for 2 years for scratching his mom's car while joyriding. Or this young man, who as a teenager was locked up for months for throwing a piece of steak at his mom's boyfriend.
I really couldn't believe that being accused of something like throwing a steak was all that was needed to be put away.
The case of the two Pennsylvania judges in bed with local private prisons could be just the tip of the iceberg. A recent report revealed America's largest prison corporations pour hundreds of thousands into the campaigns of governors, state legislators, and judges in the hope of advancing their agenda. And it seems to be working. The number of private prisons in the U.S. is growing rapidly.
All of their money, every penny they get, is a taxpayer dollar that they get from the government. And so what they do is they get the money from the government to house prisoners, then they turn around and spend some of that money by giving it back to the politicians that push the laws and the policies that lead to both more people being incarcerated and more people being incarcerated in private prisons. So it's almost a money laundering of tax dollars.
They're making contributions to judges in electoral politics. It's sort of like a closed circuit. You're making contributions to people who are making the laws, and then you're making contributions to people who are enforcing the laws.
With the number of prisons, up goes the number of prisoners. The U.S. has around 2.3 million people behind bars.
We've seen prison populations pretty consistently over the last three decades move up a couple percent a year. And, you know, unfortunately, as a citizen, that's not the most exciting statistic. However, when you look at it from a business model perspective for the private operators, it's clearly good news.
The good news for the prison business turned into a nightmare for thousands of underage victims of the two judges in Pennsylvania.
There's an incentive in private industry, obviously, to make money. That's what private industry is for. So there's an incentive to have more prisoners, an incentive to keep those prisoners incarcerated for longer periods of time. There's really no incentive for rehabilitation. The incentives are reversed.
The so-called Cash for Kids case in Pennsylvania showed just how reversed the incentives can be, and raise the question, with judges actually interested in sending people away for longer terms and keeping their benefactors' private prisons full, what justice can one count on? I'm Gayane Chichakyan reporting from Washington, RT.